Hello everyone and welcome to the demo video of Mobile Connect, the mobile app for Amazon Connect. First of all, what is Mobile Connect? Well, it's a native mobile app for iOS and Android that allows you to handle all Amazon Connect interactions on your mobile device or even on your tablet. Now, who is it that uses this type of app? It's not contact center agents. Our typical users are people outside of the contact center, and that can be insurance brokers, claim handlers, private bankers, field technicians, doctors, nurses, anyone basically who is outside of your contact center but still benefits from being within the Amazon Connect flow. Typical reasons for our customers to use the application is security, because everything happens within Amazon Connect, but definitely also the recordings, the transcription, and all the analytics of these calls, of these mobile calls, are directly available in Amazon Connect. What is it exactly that we support? You can basically do all interactions that you can handle on your desktop version, also on the mobile version. So inbound, outbound voice, but you can also handle incoming chats, WhatsApp, and SMS messages. I will show you everything of these channels later on in this video. One question that I already want to tackle up front and that we get quite early in the discussion usually is, do you support single sign-on, so SSO? And the answer there is yes. We support all the single sign-on providers that Amazon Connect supports. So that means if you want to log in with Microsoft Azure or Salesforce, all of that is possible. And then users have the exact same experience in the mobile app as they would have on the desktop version. The application itself, it's an app like any other. You just download it from the iOS App Store or the Google Play Store. You install it on your phone and then you will have this nice green icon on your phone here. Now, if I open the Mobile Connect applications, we arrive on what we call your home screen or your recent screen. Now, you should know that everything that you do on the desktop version and on the mobile version is constantly in sync. So it doesn't matter if that call happened on the desktop or on the mobile, your recent calls will always appear here in the overview. In the top right, you see a small avatar that allows me to switch my status. So if I hit the avatar, I am in the possibility to switch my status to, for example, lunch, and then I won't be receiving any inbound calls. But I can, of course, also change my status to available, and then I'm, as a mobile worker or field agent, available for incoming calls. Now, typically, those people are not staring at their phone all day. They're probably out serving customers, and they should be able to receive interactions. Now, let's assume that someone dials into a queue, and I have a separate phone here. Someone dials into the queue. This is exactly how it will look like for that field agent. You get an incoming call that says Mobile Connect audio, and you can immediately see who's calling. So in this case, Patty Lucas is calling, and I will pick up this call. From the moment that I pick up this call, I am connected to my customer. Know that everything you see here is happening on Amazon Connect. So if you have recordings enabled, transcriptions enabled, all of that is available directly in Amazon Connect. First of all, I can see who's calling, Patty Lucas, and I can also see a bunch of additional data. With Amazon Connect, you have the ability to add data attributes to your call, and we have the possibility to show those data attributes to the user as well. So in my case, I can see the name, the location, and the language of the customer that is calling, but this is fully configurable, of course. You also see a link with Salesforce Contact. This is the app-to-app integration that we have with Salesforce, but you can basically set it up with any other CRM system as well. What will happen if I click the Salesforce contact button is it will ask me to open up an external link, and it will automatically bring me to a specific contact in Salesforce. So here, this is the Salesforce app that automatically pops open, and I can immediately see all the information in Salesforce about this specific customer. Now, this is one way to go from Mobile Connect to Salesforce, but there is also another way, is that you go to Salesforce, you go to a specific contact like I've done here, and if you hit the mobile call button at the top of your Salesforce app, you will be able to dial out via Mobile Connect. So it works in two directions. You can either go from Mobile Connect to Salesforce, or via Salesforce, you can start a call via Mobile Connect. Now, if I go back to my Mobile Connect application and the call that I currently have, you also see that you have all your call controls available that you would expect. You can switch your audio to headphones or your AirPods that you're using, for example. You can put the customer on hold and you can mute yourself. What is interesting is that you can also go into a consult, same functionality as you have on Amazon Connect Desktop. If you hit consult, you are able to see all your Amazon Quick Connects and you can connect with someone else, and then you will go into a conference call with that other person. So it's definitely possible to also have a conference call or a consult on the mobile app itself. From the moment that I would release this call, it ends the interaction. I can close the interaction afterwards, and then I go back to my recent screen and I'm available again to take my next call. So that's the inbound call. The outbound calling works exactly the same. There are multiple ways to start an outbound call, but one of them is, for example, to go to contacts. And in my contacts, I have all my local contacts synced up. And I can, for example, select Patty Lucas. I see all the numbers that Patty Lucas has connected to it. I choose to dial the mobile number and it starts dialing out. Again, this call is happening on Amazon Connect. From the moment that my customer picks up, I'm connected to my customer and I have, again, all my call controls available. Same thing, if I would end this call again, it ends the interaction, I close the interaction, and it brings me back to the app where I was before. The handling of digital interaction works in a similar way. If someone would send a chat message, for example, but it works the same for WhatsApp and SMS, it would just arrive as a digital interaction. And as you can see, here is an example of that. You get a digital interaction that you can accept or reject. In my case, I will accept this question from Pat Thompson. Once I accept, it allows me to chat with my customer. I can send emojis, I can send files. Everything that you would expect from a digital interaction application is also available here. So this works for SMS, WhatsApp, and for chat. All those channels, if you handle them via Amazon Connect, your mobile users will also be able to handle them on the mobile device. Same principle, if I end this chat, it brings me back to where I was in the application, and I can continue working as I was doing before. Furthermore, we have, of course, all your contacts. So you have your external contacts and you have your quick connects that are set up in Amazon Connect, but they are available here in the mobile app as well. You have a keypad. I think that's quite self-explanatory. You can type in a number and just dial out to any number of your preference. And you have a number of settings. Now, I won't dwell too long on any of those settings. I think there is one important thing that I do want to mention here, is that we have the option to switch between soft phone and desk phone. So soft phone is dialing out via WebRTC over the internet, but we do have a number of use cases where people are sometimes in remote areas with a bad internet connection. And in those cases, the users have the option to switch to desk phone. What will happen is that instead of using the internet, it will use your normal SIM card and it will use your cellular connection to make the call. All the analytics and recording and all the features of Amazon Connect will still be available. It's just a different way of placing the calls in case you have a bad internet connection. Those were the core features that I wanted to demo in this video. As you've noticed, we try to keep the app as simple and as usable as possible, knowing that our users are people outside of the contact center. So we want to make it as easy as possible to take and make calls via our application. If what you just saw seems interesting for your organization, you can find us on AWS Marketplace. So we are publicly available there. And we also are free trial enabled. So that means you can do a 10-day free trial of our application. In those 10 days, you can just test it out for free, unlimited use. And if you like it, you can afterwards purchase a subscription. The pricing of our application is rather simple. You just buy per packs of 10 users. So 10 is the minimum amount of users that we request. and you just pay $29.99 per user per month. If you would commit to higher volumes or for a longer period of time, please don't hesitate to reach out to us, and then we can set up a private offer via AWS Marketplace. I hope this demo video was insightful to you and your organization. If you have any questions, technical or commercial whatsoever, please let us know. I'll put our contact details below this video so that you can easily reach out to us. Wishing you a great day and hope to speak to you soon and see you soon on the Mobile Connect.